We require more isopods.
Willst du spazieren gehen?
When taking my dog for a walk in the morning, I noticed some isopods of the roly-poly variety. Today I decided to collect some. I found them not in a park-like environment or a garden or a forest, but sticking to the walls of houses, right next to the street.
Auf der Mauer, auf der Lauer sitzt ne kleine Assel. Auf der Mauer, auf der Lauer sitzt ne kleine Assel.
Those are the ones that I got. Now, I do have some history with isopods. For example, I have vivid memories of a science fair in elementary school where I presented a bunch of isopods and I was very impressed by their color variation. Time to ID my catch. Now I can confidently say they are isopods, so no millipedes or something. Therefore, I will start at the Isopoda page of my identification key. Don't worry, I won't go through all the minutiae of the identification key, but I will address some important points and the less obscure ones. Most likely they are just the most common variety of pilbug, Armadillidium vulgare, but we shall see. First, the most obvious points. They are not marine, but land dwellers. Therefore, Oniscidea. They have tracheal systems for breathing air. They have normal eyes and the tips of their second antennae are too segmented, I think. Yeah, and of course they have the ability to roll up into a ball, although they are not doing it right now. Am I not threatening enough or what? Anyway, they did curl up when I first picked them up. So we arrive at Armadillidiidae, which in my area includes only the genus Armadillidium, and this only has 5 species. Is there a double or a single line in their faces? I can't really tell, but based on the size of the largest specimen alone, I'm pretty sure it has to be Armadillidium vulgare, which is the most common species. And that's of course assuming they all belong to the same species and there's no exotic species involved, but since I found them outside, that's rather unlikely, I think. My original plan was to use them as cleanup crew in a container for indigenous snails, but I figured they should first reproduce and build up a small colony, and so I'm putting them into a temporary container first. Their first meal is some leftover triops food. They seem to like it. So this is the second isopod species I'm keeping at the moment. The other one, as I mentioned in an earlier video, they came to me, basically, and it was the dwarf striped isopod Nagurus cristatus. Probably. And this now is Armadillidium vulgare, which I picked up deliberately. Those individuals are not especially colorful, but there is some variation in color, so it should be interesting to breed them. Oh, and the big one has already had enough and is going into hiding. By the way, here we can see a typical trait of the Armadillidiidae, which is that the uropods are flattened and do not stick out. Otherwise, they would be quite cumbersome when rolling into a ball, I guess. And with this educational booty view, we end the video.